Vedic literature, as the earliest existing literature, is the original cultural heritage of humanity, as it contains side-by-side descriptions of material and spiritual knowledge, relevant for both the social and spiritual upliftment of humanity at large. Indeed, ceremonial incantations of Sanskrit texts have been scientifically proven as a favorable method for personal development. Thus, Vedic literature ought to occupy a significant place in the life of society today. These sacred teachings are not inventions of any ordinary person. They are apurusheya, of transcendental origin. The Supreme Personality of Godhead, Shri Krishna himself, bestowed them to Lord Brahma, who in turn transmitted them through an uninterrupted disciplic succession. It was Srila Vyasadeva who anticipated the deterioration of culture due to the influence of the age of Kali. He could see that the lifespan of people in general would be reduced and that they would be impatient due to lack of goodness. Thus he contemplated a solution for the welfare of all people so that they could purify themselves simply by following their prescribed occupations. Knowing that the sacrifices mentioned in the Vedas were means by which people's occupations could be engaged in the Lord's service, he wrote down the Vedic scriptures and developed them so that they would suit all classes of human beings. For centuries, these masterpieces have been unknown to most of humanity, and their most essential teaching, love for the Supreme Lord, Sri Krishna, as the ultimate purpose of human life, has remained hidden within the complex Sanskrit language and even misrepresented by various scholars. Fortunately, spiritual masters of the disciplic succession known as the Sri Brahma Madhva Gaudiya Sampradaya have collected many of these scriptures for research work with the aim of revealing those most essential teachings of the Vedas for the benefit of all human beings. Finally, His Divine Grace Sri Srimad A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, a follower in the disciplic succession of those same spiritual masters, established the International Society for Krishna Consciousness in order to systematically propagate that spiritual knowledge to the society at large and to educate people in the techniques of spiritual life in order to check the imbalance of the values of life and to achieve real unity and peace in the world. The principles of Vedic knowledge are eternal and fully relevant even now in this contemporary age because they provide insight into all aspects of life. Readers will find Vedic scripture of value for many reasons. For those interested in comparative philosophy and religion, they offer an enlightening view into the Vedas. To sociologists, they explain the perfectly organized Vedic social system, also known as Varnashram Dharma, which presents a perfect world view. To students of literature, they are simply a majestic masterpiece of poetry. For psychologists, the texts provide perspectives on the nature of consciousness, human behavior, and the philosophical study of identity. For those seeking spiritual enlightenment, they offer simple and practical guidance for the attainment of self-realization and realization of the absolute truth. Most importantly, however, Vedic scriptures propagate that humanity should accept a common cause, to rediscover one's constitutional position as an eternal servant of the Supreme Lord, Sri Krishna. Therefore, this enlightening education should be propagated for the development of human civilization. In this way, society at large can reach an elevated state of affection for the Supreme Personality of Godhead, develop compassion towards all living beings, and shall flourish in accomplishment of complete and perfect unity, solidarity, and prosperity.